Welcome to an example on how to find the equation of a transformed square root function. In this question, we're asked to find the equation of the blue square root function based upon a transformation of the basic square root function graphed here in red. So we'll call the transformed function g of x and the basic square root function f of x. Before we find the equation of the transformed function, we want to be able to recognize what transformation has occurred resulting in g of x. We'll notice the square root function starts at the origin, or the point 0, 0, and moves toward the right, but our transformed function starts at the point negative 2, negative 3, and moves to the left. So because it moves to the left, we should recognize that f of x has been reflected across the y-axis, and then also it's been shifted left 2 units and down 3 units. So let's go ahead and write this down. Number one, we have a reflection across the y-axis. Number two, we have a shift left 2 units. And number three, we have a shift down 3 units. So let's first write g of x in terms of f of x using function notation, and then we'll actually write the equation for g of x. Before we do this, let's review how these three transformations affect g of x. First, y equals f of negative x reflects f of x across the y-axis. So looking at the red square root function below, we would have y equals the square root of negative x. And we have to be a little careful here because we have other transformations. So this negative sign here would be applied to the entire radicand, or the expression underneath the square root. We're actually changing the sign of the entire input into f. Next, since we have a horizontal shift left, y equals f of the quantity x plus c, again where c is positive, will shift the graph of f of x left c units. So looking at this green square root function, y equals the square root of the quantity x plus 2 will shift the graph left 2 units. Notice how the sign here is the opposite of what you might think. If it's plus a constant, it's left. If it's minus a constant, it's right for a horizontal shift. And then finally, for the vertical shift, since we have a shift down, y equals f of x minus d, again where d is positive, will shift f of x down d units. So looking at the graph of the red square root function, y equals the square root of x minus 2, where the minus 2 is not underneath the square root, would shift the function down 2 units. Let's go back to our example. Let's first write g of x in terms of f of x, and then we'll write the equation for g of x. So first we have a reflection across the y-axis, so we'd have g of x equals f of, and then we'd have a negative x as our input, and then for number 2, we're told that we have a shift left 2 units. So because it's left 2 units, we know we have to have a plus 2 here, but we have to be careful here because we actually want the x plus 2 in parentheses. So we'll have the negative sign there, and then in parentheses, x plus 2. So this will be a reflection across the y-axis and a shift left 2 units. If we don't have these parentheses, it would actually not be the correct transformation. And then finally, we have a shift down 3 units, so we'd have a minus 3 on the end here. Which means the equation for g of x would be g of x equals the square root of negative the quantity x plus 2, and then minus 3. A common error in this problem is to leave off the parentheses here, and we'll take a look at the graph in just a moment and see how it would not give us the correct transformed graph. So let's finish by graphing the transformed function and the basic square root function on the graphing calculator to verify our work. So we'll press y equals, and we'll type in the basic square root function first. So second x squared, x, close parenthesis, enter. And then we'll have second x squared for the square root. Then we're going to have a negative sign, or the opposite of the quantity x plus 2. Notice how we need two closed parentheses here. 1 for the quantity x plus 2 and 1 for the square root, and then minus 3. To make sure we have the standard window, let's go ahead and press zoom 6. So there's the basic square root function, and here's our transform function. Notice how it has been reflected across the y-axis, shifted left 2 units and down 3 units. Let's finish by taking a look at what happens if we leave off these parentheses. So in y3, we'll enter square root negative x plus 2 without the parentheses, and then minus 3. And what we'll see is this actually shifts the graph 2 units right instead of 2 units left. When we have multiple transformations, or specifically when we have a reflection across the y-axis and a shift left or right, we do need to be careful how we set up the function. I hope you found this explanation helpful.